Community.
Against you,
Every power that comes to kill, to steal, to destroy, the blood goes against you. Every power that comes to devour, the blood goes against you. Every thief, spiritual thief, physical thief, the blood goes against you. In the name of the Lord, God, from the first place of prosper. Everything around the beginning of judgment, in the name of Jesus, be destroyed, be condemned. In the name of Jesus, the blood.
No, I the blood, the blood. No, Lord Jesus, I pray. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, vibrate that concerns you, vibrate that concerns us. The blood. No bone from against us shall prosper. In the name of every manipulation, every lies, every deception, every gathering of the wicked against our lives. The name of Jesus will destroy, destroy. Everything that shall gather will scatter. In the name of your true fraud and true greed, the true lies. In the name of Jesus, do deception. Everything that shall gather, the blood just against you. You will not prosper. In the name of Jesus. Every power frustrating our effort. Every power stealing our effort. Massive fire of God scatter everything that you have gathered. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Run on the mountain in the air. Run the mountain in the air. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus.
Yeah. King of kings, Lord of all, I worship you. King of kings, Lord of lords, King of kings, Lord of hosts, I worship you. King of kings, Lord of all, I worship you, I worship you. King of kings, Lord of all, mighty God, great I am, and Prince of peace. King of kings, Lord of all, I worship you. Oh, the God, yeah. Oh, the God, yeah. Oh, the God, yeah. Only go and give to so go and only go and go
investment, not only financial investment, but financial investment is included. But those things, those investments are invested to your own life, to be healthy in the name of Jesus. No power assigned to destroy your investment over your own health will succeed in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, over the work of my hand, over my head, over all that concerns me. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I will pray for victory, Lord Jesus, every day of our lives, in the name of Jesus. Victory over powers, victory over forces, victory over principalities and powers, victory, 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 victory over every contending power, victory, victory over every enemy, over every manipulation, in the name of Jesus. Victory, Lord Jesus, over every power, Lord, I want to put you down. Victory in the name of Jesus. I see divine victory, divine. I will not destroy what I have built with my own hand. In the name of Jesus, I will not destroy the what I have built with my hand, own hand. In the name of Jesus. As a king, as a leader, as a president, as a prime minister, my general, as a manager, I will not destroy what I have built with my own hand. In the name of Jesus, every spirit of mistake, the blood of Jesus against you. You will not succeed in my life in the name of Jesus. I will not destroy what I have built. In the name of Jesus, every power I want to manipulate, using witchcraft means, using demonic means, to steal, to kill, to destroy my glory. In the name of Jesus, they will not succeed. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, frustrate the plans of the thieves. Frustrate the plans of those who are there to kill, to steal, to destroy. Then they may frustrate them. Any frustrate, in the name of Jesus. I will not use anger to destroy the work of my hand. I will not use impatience to destroy the work of my hand. I will not use, oh Lord Jesus, my unforgiveness to destroy the work of my hand. I will not use, oh Lord Jesus, my right distraction to destroy the work of my hands. In the name of Jesus, my right prayer anymore. I will not use stubbornness to destroy the work of my hand. In the name of Jesus, run in the most of the worship here. Black eyed over the most of the world there. Name the man in the back. Every spirit of destruction, every spirit of destruction, the blood of Jesus against you. In the name of Jesus, I will not use my hand, my mouth to destroy my children. I will not use my mouth to destroy my relationship. I will not use my mouth to destroy the work of my hand. I will not use my hand to destroy the work, master my investment. In the name of Jesus, master, I will not use it. I will not allow negative imagination to steal, to destroy. In the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus against you. The blood of Jesus against you. My right hand, every blood I come to kill, to steal, to destroy. The blood of Jesus against you. The blood of Jesus against you. The blood of Jesus against you. In the name of Jesus, I recover all that I have lost. I recover my time. I recover. In the name of Jesus, mark up higher than all the master there. I will not destroy the work of my hands. In the name of Jesus, Father, Lord, your mercy will I pray. Your mercy will I pray. Over every way of my life, all we have sinned against you, Lord. All we have opened the door to the enemy. Let your mercy forgive me. Let your mercy deliver me, Lord Jesus. From every sin, Lord. From every sin, Lord. I will not destroy the works of my hand. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Jesus has set me free. That Lord of Jesus has set me free. That Lord of Jesus set me free from powers of darkness. The blood of Jesus set me free. The blood of Jesus set me free. The blood of Jesus set me free.
Thank you, Jesus. We lift them high, Lord Jesus, above every contention, above every evil, above every spirit of accusations, above every manipulations. Father, Lord, we lifted her, 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 we lifted her. In every circumstance of belief in her, Lord Jesus. Ma kopo ro de riba zani mosto de ya. Belief the, belief the, belief the, belief the. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we pray. You welcome again, my brothers and sisters, tonight. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. How have been your day? I believe your day has been very wonderful. Hallelujah. And I pray in the name of Jesus that tonight the Lord will do something great in our lives that we'll never forget, in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, once again, Lord, we pray this session to you in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Come down, Lord, as we go through your word, Lord. Speak to us, Lord Jesus. Open our eyes of understanding, Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Reveal deep things, Lord Jesus, of your word to us tonight, Lord Jesus. In your name alone, continue to be glorified in the name of Jesus. Every arrow and every wickedness on my back, I pour you the blood of Jesus, and I destroy your works in the name of Jesus. Ratayrebo, from the crown of my head to my feet, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we give you praise, Lord. Right now, we're going to go straight down to the book of Psalm chapter 101, from verse 1 to 8. And after that, we'll proceed to Romans chapter 8. Hallelujah. Then after that, we enter to the session of our confessions. Hallelujah. God bless you all in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord Jesus, I pray that you touch men, women, you touch community tonight. Ma san ne mo ro ire ya. Gra ka pa ire bo de ne. Ne ma ka ire bo ro ire ya. Father, Lord, as everyone that will go come across me tonight, every power that come across me tonight, in the name of, I pray in the name of God that the spiritual master, that they will have dominion over every power, over every forces. In the name of God, reveal to them, O Lord Jesus, the issues in their life. Reveal to them, O Lord God, the issues in their life. Reveal to them, O Lord, the issues in their life. And move tonight, O Lord. Your name alone be glorified. Blessed be your holy name. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, amen. And before we continue, I remember, I just remember something now. I was when we prayed, and you know, the message when we are praying, you listen to us very well. You say, I will not destroy the works of my hand in the name of Jesus. I want us to do the same prayer, to pray and for our leaders in the name of Jesus. Our leaders will not destroy. In the name of the Lord, give them wisdom, knowledge, understanding. Those who are in government or in a very sensitive position, that the Lord will give them the grace to understand what is happening in their life. In the name of Jesus, every spirit of arrogance, every spirit of blindness, the Lord remove. In the name of Jesus, the power that want to destroy the works of their hand, they want to destroy what they have built. In the name of Jesus, they will not succeed. In the name of Jesus, if you're in a place, especially if you're in a position of power, especially that you know, we have a lot of people, we are not the only one there. Like here, we are the only one. And again, we listen to people, we listen to suggestions. Hallelujah. But if you are in a place where you are like a governor, a president, if you are a manager and all those stuff, always listen to those who are with you, listen to them. The voice of men, most times the voice of God. Listen to them. Don't just forcefully to take decision on your own. One thing you need to understand in this life, that human beings will promise you things, but unfortunately, when things come tough, they will deny you. When things come tough, they will deny you. Remember that even, hallelujah, husbands deny their wife. Wife denies husband. Children deny their parents. When things become tough, It's only few that can stand to the end. Very few. Just down to the end. Hallelujah. May God help us in the name of Jesus. Always remember that. And therefore, don't just, stick your heart or stick your mind what the decision you think you hear or think you think is right. Just stick your heart and begin to do it. Or else you are shooting yourself on your foot. You are shooting your ankle. You end up falling, Yakata. May God help us in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let's always listen. Hallelujah. And especially some of us who are those who are in a leadership position, if you know very well, because identify to a spiritual leader that your spirit is in agreement with, associate with that spiritual leader. It doesn't matter if they are Christian, or probably your religion is total, you can see that sincerity in them. Associate, discuss your issue with them. Hallelujah. Discuss your issue with them. And the process, allow God, to just have a clean heart and a simple heart, a heart of an open heart. Then would that be able to overcome issues. Hallelujah. You can see this very advice that I gave now in the Bible. Hallelujah. When the kings were, when they become, troubled and they don't know what to do, they always run to Samuel. Samuel will, as a spiritual leader, Eli as a spiritual leader, they will consult them and they will help them and see them like Elijah, Elisha. They see the mind of God running to an issue. Because those ones, they are interested. Those ones are not looking for money. Those ones who are lobbying around you for money, don't even use them. It doesn't matter even if they are the spiritual head of the community or the country or whatever. Don't go to them. But those one who doesn't take money for anything, who doesn't value money, those who value the position the Lord has put them, you can see them, you know them. Those who always come to sing your praises, oh, you are this, you are that, don't involve them into a spiritual matter. Hallelujah. They're just there for their own ego, for their own belly. May God help us in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So that you can rule in uprightness, you can rule in justice. You can rule, hallelujah, so that your throne can last, or else disaster is coming. May God help us in Jesus' name. Every nation, every country in this world today, we have problems. There's problems everywhere. Try to take responsibility and follow the right path. Hallelujah. And again, even if you're not a Christian, study the Old Testament. If you study the Old Testament, let me say that the Old Testament is actually the manual for our life here on earth. The manual to live a victorious life here on earth, the Old Testament. Then if you want to live above this earth, then New Testament. Hallelujah. Because Jesus Christ will give you eternal life. Hallelujah. The law of Moses will give you, it's not going to give you eternal life, it just give you the grace to overcome the challenges of this world. Hallelujah. And that is recognized everywhere. Either you're a Christian or not, it's recognized. And therefore, try to, even if you're not a Christian, read the Old Testament. It will help you so much. Hallelujah. Your pursuit of authority and power to help you so much, to guide you right. Seriously, to help you. Hallelujah. Because there's nothing that is happening today in the world that have not happened before. Nothing that is happening now that have never happened before. Day by day, people keep discovering mind-blowing technologies, mind-blowing structures and things that they cannot even put their head together, that even more sophisticated than our technology today. That's what the Bible says. Nothing that is happening now that have never happened before. May God help us in the name of, and therefore there is that situation that we are going through. It has happened before. Go to the Bible, you will see it. Hallelujah. God bless us. in Jesus' name. Now let's go to Psalm 101. Hallelujah. And I pray God will give us wisdom tonight in the name of God and deliver us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Psalm from verse 1 to the end. We're going to read it via the computer. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Psalm 101, a psalm of David. I will sing of steadfast love and justice. To you, O Lord, I will make music. I will ponder the way that is blameless. O, when will you come to me? I will walk with integrity of heart within my house. I will not set before my eyes anything that is worthless. I hate the work of those who fall away. It shall not cling to me.
Mm-hmm.
A perverse heart shall be far from me. I will know nothing of evil. Whoever slanders his neighbor secretly, I will destroy. Whoever has a haughty look and an arrogant heart, I will not endure. I will look with favor on the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me. He who walks in the way that is blameless shall minister to me. No one who practices deceit shall dwell in my house. No one who utters lies shall continue before my eyes. Morning by morning I will destroy all the wicked in the land, cutting off all the evildoers from the city of the Lord.
May God help us in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of wickedness in us, in the name of God, command all wickedness to lose your hold over our lives. In the name of Jesus, I refuse to be among the people the Lord will destroy. And I refuse, you and me, our place, hallelujah, our family, our community, will not be among those places that the Lord will destroy. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But we receive salvation from God. He said, morning by morning, I will destroy all the wicked in the land, cutting off all the evildoers from the city of the Lord. Hallelujah. I will not be among, wicked will not dwell in me. Because if wicked is seeing you, you'll be destroyed. Wicked will not be seen in the life of the Lord. Why is the Lord saying this in his word? Not to call your attention of judgment that is coming soon. Why you have been compromising? You have been, you know, making people to fight, and you know, in their presence, you appear to be that you are fully in support of them, but behind you are actually, you know, igniting the fire of war. You are there rejoicing of the evil that you are causing, because you have an interest. You are supplying something, or there's a business that is underground. You activate it, you set that fire so you can start supplying wood. Because the more the fire burn, definitely you need wood, more wood to ignite the fire. Yes, that's what is happening today in our world. May God deliver us in the name of Jesus. But if you're in such kind of situation and you're living that kind of life, my brother and sister, desist from it. Desist from it. The Lord says he's going to destroy you. I will not be among those that the Lord will destroy. My loved ones will not be among those that the Lord will destroy. We repent from all our sins, O Lord Jesus. We turn from our wicked ways, O Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Someone will tell me, I have been doing this for a long time. Have God destroyed me? I've destroyed a lot of lives. A lot of generations have ruined. Why is it that I've not been destroyed? Remember, it's not the very day that Saul started his wickedness that he perished. It's not the very day that the king Nebuchadnezzar started his wickedness that he perished. God gave room upon room upon room. But when they refused to repent, the Lord still have mercy. Then at Sodom and Gomorrah, the Lord said, I will not destroy this lovely city. I want to save this lovely city. Abraham, what should we do? I want to destroy this city, but if I find just a righteous person there, I will not go ahead with this if I want to do. Because the Lord has to destroy that city. The Lord has to destroy that evil man or evil woman so that he will not continue to multiply evil in our society. and making someone the one who's supposed to be innocent to become vulnerable. May God deliver us in the name of Jesus. Now that is why the Lord has to destroy the evil. Well, some of our family, those who have been struggling, the family will struggle and struggle and struggle. One wicked uncle, one wicked somebody in your family will monitor and destroy every work of your hand. They will lead you, they will make sure you marry the wrong person, they will make sure you are into the wrong thing. They are monitoring you with everything they have. They'll be able to stop a lot of family members. It can't, the kind of destructions that some of these guys have caused in their family, probably up to 100 people or even more than. People will go to university, they will not use that paper for something reasonable. It's not that they are dull upstairs, they are not dull. They will engage their hand, even go and borrow money, invest in business, that business will never work. It's the hand of the evil, wicked souls in some families. That is their work. And probably they will try, they destroy the lights that came to the family. Any night that come, they'll put it off. The Lord said, enough is enough. I will destroy every evil in the hallelujah around you. And I pray in the name of Jesus. The Lord is sounding this one now because he doesn't want even that evil person the Lord wants to destroy. The Lord doesn't want to destroy that person because he loves him. Because he actually died for the sinner. He died for the wicked. So the wicked can come out from that wickedness. Because that wickedness, they have been... Oh, God, have mercy. Because the wickedness earlier that they're involved into, they don't really know the extent of the evil they are into. And still now, the mercy of God have been keeping them, saving them. Does not want them to die. Don't want them to be destroyed. The Lord wants to save them. Want to save them so that God can use them. Just as the Lord saved Saul and began to use him. Then God wants to save them. But if they continue, the Lord, if God exhausts every opportunity and every open doors of escape from his wrath and refuse to yield, God will not have any other option than to let them go. So they can have some fresh air in some of the families. And I pray in the name of Jesus, any power that they have decided and say over their devil to see you succeed, over their devil to see you become what God has said you must be, in the name of God, command in the name of Jesus, let the earth swallow them. He refuses to repent. In the name of Jesus, and every evil they have done in your life, every evil they have done in my life, every wickedness that I've done in my life, in the name of Jesus, I command them to be scattered. In the name of Jesus, I take back all my virtues. I take back all my glory. In the name of Jesus, I take back all the years that I've wasted in my life. In the name of restoration, in the name of Jesus, in your life. Restoration, in the name of Jesus. You take back those years from their hands. You take back those years from their hands. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you glory tonight. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Now move down to the book of Romans chapter 8, from verse 1 to end. Wickedness exists in this world. Wickedness exists. Those who are ignorant, those who are dull in the spirit, so everything is demon, everything. Of course, everything is demon. Everything is evil. You don't know it. Everything is evil. If it's not light, it's evil. Either light or darkness. Either light or darkness. Believe it. If you refuse to believe it, that doesn't make it not to be, the truth. The truth that you decided to be ignorant. God help us in the name of Jesus. Even God himself said that there's a lot of violence against the truth, violent against justice, violent against the right, you know, the right part of life. The wickedness that exists in this world, they are violently rebuking and resisting the truth from prevailing. And the Lord Jesus Christ make us to know that you have to be violent in righteousness. You have to be violent in truth. You have to be violent even in kindness. You have to be violent to take it by force. You have to be violent. Because enemy is violently want to destroy you. May God help us in the name of Jesus. Open our eyes, Lord, just to understand what is happening around us, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In Romans chapter 8 from verse 1 to end, we're going to read again our computer. Over to you.
Chapter 8. There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life has set you
You see? Exactly what we are saying now. Bible says, there is therefore now no condemnation. I mean, the powers are constantly condemning you to destroy your moral, to destroy your ecstasy, to destroy you from striving forward. Powers are always. The Lord is trying to let us know there is no condemnation. As far as you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and as He set your mind to the things, hallelujah, that profit, the eternal things. You set your mind to love, you set your mind to patience, you set your mind to kindness, you set your mind to, you know, overcome, you set your mind over the spirit that is contending against the goodness and the mercy of God over your life. You set your mind against the power that is standing against the truth, standing against justice, standing against morality, kindness, standing against justice, standing against love, standing against, you know, forgiveness. May God have mercy in the name of Jesus. There is no condemnation against those who are in Christ Jesus. When we talk about Jesus Christ, we're talking about wisdom. We're talking about faith. We're talking about love. We're talking about kindness. We're talking about joy. We're talking about power. We're talking about understanding. When we're talking about when you see Jesus there, hallelujah, because He stands as light. Hallelujah. Those who have the Spirit of Jesus, the Spirit of light dwelling in them. May God help us in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Can see the amount of light that Jesus Christ carried. That He helped Him to be all the way, millions of miles, billions of miles away. He can see the wickedness, can see the darkness. It takes someone who is super extraordinary, you know, holy, to be able to still see the dark, because the distance is too much to even to still see the darkness in the world. But He was able to see the darkness in the world. The darkness you and me cannot see, He was seeing it. Even when He had traveled to heaven, went to heaven, He was still seeing the darkness. The church of Christ, the seven churches, they were surrounded by darkness. Thinking they are in the light, dwelling so happy that you are in the light. Because Jesus Christ is extraordinary holy. Very holy, shining, bright morning star. One can still see darkness from all that, you know, billions of miles away. Now understand how holy Jesus Christ is. How truth He is. How sincere He is. Hallelujah. And I pray in the name of Jesus that His Spirit will take over us in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. We'll begin to walk in His light. We'll begin to walk in His understanding. We'll begin to walk in His might. We'll begin to walk in the name of Jesus in His kindness. We'll begin to walk in His love. In the name of Jesus. We're going to walk in the name of Jesus in His compassion, in His forgiveness. In the name of Jesus. Been there, Naraka, it was there. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Against everything that those who exalt their name against the Lord. In the name of Jesus. No condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.
Condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life has set you free in Christ Jesus from the law of sin and death.
Amen.
For God has done what the law, weakened by the flesh, could not do. By sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin, he condemned sin in the flesh, in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh. But those who live according to the Spirit set their minds on the things of the Spirit. For to set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace. For the mind that is set on the flesh is hostile to God, for it does not submit to God's law. Indeed, it cannot. Those who are in the flesh cannot please God. You, however, are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit, if in fact the Spirit of God dwells in you.
Amen.
Anyone who does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is life because of righteousness. Mm-hmm. If the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ Jesus from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his Spirit who dwells in you.
Amen.
So then, brothers, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption as sons, by whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ, provided we suffer with him in order that we may also be glorified with him. For I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory that is to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the sons of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not willingly, but because of him who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to corruption and obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation has been groaning together in the pains of childbirth until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly as we wait eagerly for adoption as sons, the redemption of our bodies. For in this hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what he sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know what to pray for as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. And he who searches hearts knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose. For those whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, in order that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those whom he predestined, he also called. Mm-hmm. And those whom he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died, more than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Yes. Shall tribulation or distress,
no,
or persecution or famine or nakedness,
no,
or danger or sword?
No.
As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No. In all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen. No power. There was a pretos in the
chapter.
Name of Jesus. No power. In the name of Jesus. No power will be able to separate us from the love of God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Verse 15 says, for you did not receive the spirit of slavery. The spirit of slavery to fall back to fear. You fall back to fear. For, you know, every evil, the destruction that is happening today in the world, in every realm of life, they have strong root what? To fear. Sin is slavery. You know, for example, now, someone can ask me, why am I saying that sin? How can sin be? Can one commit sin, guys? You know, because the things you don't want to do, you see yourself doing it. The things you know that these things are wrong, but you don't have the power to stop it. You don't have power to say, no, I'm not going to do this. That means you are subjected. You are a slave to that character. You are a slave to sin. You are a slave to that drunkenness. You are a slave to that character of yours that you're battling to stop. Unfortunately, you refuse. You know, one story I was told, I saw it because it happened when I was younger. This guy is a drunkard. He drank and drank, most time he fall into a gutter, fall into a mud. His wife in the night, when the wife waits and they not see him, you know the place where the man will be. He had finished drinking nights in the gutter. The wife will go and carry him and help him, wash him and cleanse him up. In the morning, he will tell, please stop this thing you are doing. You're going to kill yourself. You're going to kill you. Remember these children here and all those. The man continued. He got to a stage that the guy, every night after drinking, you start vomiting. Today, he will start vomiting blood. You vomit blood. But he will not stop. The sign was there for him to stop, that death is by the corner. But he refused because he cannot hold it. He cannot stop it. He was dying. Every night he must vomit blood. Because of what? Because he was under slavery. He cannot control that character. You know, some of us in some places that Lord have, you know, the place of our work. For years now, you've been stealing money. You chain the figures. You've been doing that over and over. Now, it cannot even stop it. Even though you know, very soon you'll be caught. Unfortunately, it has become part of your character. You cannot. And I pray in the name of your power. That's the reason why Jesus Christ has come to destroy every forces, every power of the wicked against your life. In the name of your power of slavery, your power of that evil habit, the blood of Jesus against you, be broken in the name of Jesus. Be set free in the name of your for the body and the shackles of this wicked spirit. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Because those children will not lose their father or their mother. In the name of Jesus. That man or that woman will not lose his or her spouse. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen. And right now, I want you to repeat these words with me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. And I have sinned against you so many ways. Forgive me. Cleanse me from all my sins, O Lord. Have mercy on me, O Lord Jesus. I accept you as my personal Lord and Savior. Come into my life in the name of Jesus. Give my life a meaning, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, I need your help, O Lord. Come down to my life, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, and help me. I surrender my all to you, Lord Jesus. Be the Lord of my life from now to the rest of my life. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Father, Lord, I pray, Lord Jesus, any association to that evil that is going on in the life of your people. I pray, Lord Jesus, that family link or that wicked witchcraft or that wicked spell, whatever evil has been done against you. You that, you know, that character started when you broke up, when you disappointed your partner. From there, strange spirit start tormenting you. You begin to see yourself doing the wrong thing that you know will not normally do because of the anger of that woman. If you're there right now, I want you to kneel down and ask God, please forgive me. Have mercy on me. Every evil that woman have done or have done in my life, hallelujah. Father, I forgive her. I forgive her in every evil that she has done. In the name of God, I forgive her, both the one I know and the one I don't know. I forgive her. Hallelujah. Because that Bible said, God said you should forgive those who sin against you so that he can forgive you. So he can now be the one who is in charge of your life. Not that evil hand that you refuse to forgive. Because whoever you refuse to forgive is in charge of some major issue that is happening in your life. Then when you forgive them, then the Lord, who is the righteous judge, will take over, hallelujah, that the throne in the name of Jesus. And therefore, Father Lord, we come again all this hour once again. We ask the Lord Jesus, hallelujah, as my brother and sister have forgiven whoever that have sinned against them that have caused this evil in their life, let your mercy in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, locate them this night. In the name of Jesus, let that yoke, whatever it might be, that evil that has been sponsored in their life for destruction, that habit that has been sponsored by that power, matter for destruction, the blood of Jesus against you. In the name of, lose your hold and break your power, break your hold. In the name of Jesus, every spiritual link and spiritual turn and spiritual spells be scattered, be destroyed. Every iron like us, the blood of Jesus against you tonight. In the name of Jesus. You break every curse. You break every wickedness of the wicked. The blood of Jesus against you. In the name of, for this call, the Lord Jesus Christ has come to destroy the works of darkness. Be free in the name of Jesus. Lose your hold, you wicked spirit, in the name of Jesus. Lose your hold in the name of Jesus. Be set free in the name of Jesus. These ones will not die, but they will live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, tonight for what you've done, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Now let's quickly go to our confessions. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. Psalm chapter 23, from verse 1 to end. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Braka pa iriboshi de. Inima san iriboro iriboshi de kia. Gaga ba ko iriba rata iriboshi de. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, your Lord, go through us, Lord. Every distraction, the blood of Jesus against you. Spirit of the living God, confess to us. In the name of Jesus, let everything that we confess in the name be released by the Spirit of God in us, in the name of Jesus. And we'll begin to see our manifestation even as we start confessing them, in the name of Jesus.
Let there be healing. Let there be deliverance. Let there be great things in the life of your people, Lord, tonight. In the name of Jesus, amen. From verse 1, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. In the name of Jesus. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in path of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valleys of shadow of death, I fear no evil. In the name of Jesus. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Man, you prepare the table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head. My head with hallelujah. 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 My son, everybody. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen and amen. Psalm 59 from verse 1 to end. Sorry, verse 1 and 2. Thank you, Jesus. Deliver me from my enemies, O my God. Protect me from those who rise up against me. Deliver me from those who work evil and save me from bloodthirsty men. In the name of Jesus, once again, deliver us from our enemies, O our God. Protect us from those who rise up against us. Deliver us from those who work evil and save us from bloodthirsty men. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen. Blessed be your holy name. Psalm 91 from verse 1 to end. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge, my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler, from the deadly pestilence. In the name of Jesus, he will cover you with his pinion, and under his wings you will find refuge. In the name of Jesus. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. You will not fear the terrors of the night, nor the arrow that fly by day, nor the pestilence that stalk in darkness, nor the destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. In the name of Jesus. Marana, you will only look with your eyes and see the recompense of the wicked. In the name of you, because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, the Most High, who is my refuge. No evil shall be allowed to befall me, you. No plague will come near your tent, for he will command his angel concerning you to guide you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up. You will not strike your foot against those. In the name of Jesus, you will tread on the lion and the adder, the young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. In the name of Jesus, because you hold fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. When he calls to me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. Hallelujah. I will rescue him and I will honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Raki posedeye. Nini ma kairebo ro kerea. Nana masa kairebo ro ireba shidegea. Nide geba kairebo ro irebo stea. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Raka pairebos dea. Hallelujah. Psalm 144 from verse 1 to end. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My son in the morning. Begeba kapairebo roi rebosh dia. Ma kapairebo roi rebosh rebosh dia. Nini ma san rebo roi rebosh kea. Braga bairebo se rebosh dia. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be the Lord, my rock, who trains my hands for war and my fingers for battle. He is my steadfast love and my fortress, my stronghold and my deliverer. Hallelujah. My shield in whom I take refuge, who subdues people under me. Oh Lord, what is a man that you regard him? Or a son of man that you think of him? Run in the most area. Man is like a breath, his days like a passing shadow. Man, Sunday, bow your heavens, O Lord, and come down. Tore the mountain, saw the smoke. Flash forth your arrow. Flash forth the arrow. Flash forth the lightning and scatter them. Send out your arrow and root them. Stretch out your hand from on high. In the name of Jesus. Master, rescue me and deliver me. from many waters, from the hands of the foreigners, whose mouth speaks lies, in the name of Jesus, whose right hand is the right hand of falsehood. Man, deliver me, O Lord. Deliver us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. I will sing a new song to you, O God. Upon a ten-string harp, I will play to you, who gave victory to kings, who rescued David, his servant, from a cruel sword. Jesus, rescue me and deliver me. In the name of Jesus, amen. From the hands of the foreigners, whose mouth speaks lies, whose right hand is right hand of falsehood. In the name of Jesus, may our sons in their youth be like plant full grown, our daughters like a corner pillar, called for the structure of a palace. In the name of Jesus, may our granary be full, providing all kinds of produce. May our sheep bring 4,000 and 10,000 in our field. In the name of Jesus, may our cattle be heavy with young, suffering no mishap or failure in bearing. In the name of Jesus, my son, may there be no cry of distress in our streets. In the name of Jesus, blessed are the people to whom such blessing fall. Blessed are the people whose God is the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Now we go to the last, our confession. Blessed be your holy name, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name, Lord Jesus. Psalm 124 from verse 1 to end. If it had not been the Lord who was on the side of the time with Jesus Christ's ministry, the time, hallelujah, who was, if it had not been the Lord who was on the side of Ernest, side of Samuel, side, hallelujah, of Isis, side, if it had not been the Lord who was on the side of the United Kingdom, hallelujah, side of Biafra, side of Israel, side of all the countries of the world, hallelujah, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, in the name of your light, all of us saved. Not the if there had been the Lord who was on our side. Hallelujah. When people rose up against us, they would have swallowed us up alive. When their anger was kindled against us, then the flood would have swept us away. The torrent would have gone over us. Then over us would have gone the raging waters. But blessed be the Lord who has not given us as a prey to their teeth. We have escaped like a bird from the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken, we have escaped, because our help is in the name of the Lord who made the heaven and the earth. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you glory for what you've done in our life tonight. Blessed be your holy name. In the name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your holy name, Jesus. Amen and amen. Now tonight we say, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord protect you. May the Lord smile on you. May the Lord be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you his peace. In the name of Jesus. Have a very wonderful night rest. In the name of Jesus. The rest of God will be here again in the morning. For those who can, please share our message and join us in the morning. In the name of Jesus. Very, very vital. Very, very vital. Don't take things for granted. Join us as we pray in the morning and the evening times. God bless you all. Hallelujah. And have a very wonderful and a pleasant night rest. Wake up strong and healthy in the name of God. Pray for those who are sick. As you go to that bed, you wake up strong. You wake up healthy. You wake up in the name of Jesus. Master, better than how you went to that bed. In the name of Jesus, 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 I will decree that, and we soak that with the blood of Jesus. So shall it be. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Love you all, and have a pleasant night rest. Shalom to you all. In Jesus' name, we pray. Love you all. Mark up.